Good morning, girls. So today's topic will be under the same chapter, gravitation. Now today's topic will be variation of gravity along with the depth. So today's topic will be now variation of gravity along with the depth. So now what is the meaning of that? Now let us see. Now this will be our own planet Earth. Now this will be our own planet Earth of mass M and radius capital R. So now you already know. Now as long, so let us see, we are placing a body on the surface of the Earth, or let us say we are keeping a body of mass M on the surface of the Earth, and you already know, now as long as the body will be on the surface of the Earth, then the gravity will always be maximum, that will be equal to G. So let us see, the gravity on the surface of the Earth will be equal to G. So once again, now remember, now consider our own planet Earth of mass M and radius capital R. Now what I am doing, I am keeping a body of mass M on the surface of the Earth, and you know, now as long as the body will be kept on the surface of the Earth, then the gravity will always be maximum, that will be equal to G. So now what we are doing, so now the body will be made to penetrate now deeper and deeper into the Earth crust. So remember, now what we are doing, now the same body is made to penetrate now deeper and deeper now under the Earth crust. So now I want to find now what will be the expression for the gravity, or what will be the formula for the gravity at any depth d from the surface of the Earth. So if you look at the diagram, now let us see, you can clearly see in the diagram the body will be penetrating now deeper and deeper into the Earth crust. Now let us say the depth of the body from the surface of the Earth will be small d. So remember, the depth will be denoted by a letter small d. So let us assume, now let the depth of the body from the surface of the Earth will be small d. Then you already know, then what will be the distance of the body, or what will be the present distance of the body from the center. Now remember, now the present distance of the body from the center will be R minus D. So by looking at the diagram, it is very clear. Now initially, now what I am doing, I am keeping the body on the surface of the Earth, and you already know, now as long as the body will be kept on the surface of the Earth, then the gravity will always be maximum. mum, that will be equal to G. So now, what I am doing? So now, the body is made to penetrate, or now, the body is made to penetrate, not deeper and deeper, not under the earth crust. So now, let us assume, now let that depth of the body from the surface of the earth, or let us say that depth of the body from the surface of the earth will be small d, then you already know. So now that distance of the body from the center of the earth will be equal to now r minus d. So meaning what? The radius of the outer sphere will be r, and the radius of the inner sphere will be r minus d. So now very clear, from the given diagram, now the radius of the outer sphere will be capital R, and the radius of the inner sphere will be R minus D. And remember, so now my intention will be to determine now what will be the gravity at that depth, or now I want to obtain the expression for the gravity now at that particular depth, now denoted by a letter GD. So now let us try to find out now what will be the expression we got for the gravity at any depth now below the surface of the earth. So now very simple, first I can write down now gravity on the surface of the earth. So now I can write down now gravity on the surface of the earth. So gravity on the surface of the earth. So gravity on the surface of the earth. Now small g will be numerically equal to, now what we are doing? So now I am writing the formula for the gravity on the surface of the earth in terms of the density of the earth. So you remember, now what is the formula we got? Or you remember, now what is the formula we got for the gravity on the surface of the earth in terms of the density? Now you remember, now the gravity on the surface of the earth in terms of density will be given by the formula. Now G will be numerically equal to KR into rho. So now I can write down now the gravity on the surface of the earth. Now small g will be numerically equal to, now I can write now KR into rho. Now let us say, now this will be our equation 1. So remember, now what I am doing, I am writing the expression for the gravity on the surface of the earth in terms of the density of the earth. So you already know it will be given by the formula. Now G will be numerically equal to KRO, or the gravity will be given by the formula KRO. Now similarly, now what will be the gravity now at that particular depth, or what will be the gravity now at that particular depth? Now let us find out now what will be the gravity at that depth. So now I can write now gravity at that depth. So gravity at that depth is, now I can write, now GD will be numerically equal to, now can anybody now tell me now what will be the gravity at that particular depth, or what will be the gravity on the inner sphere? So now very simple, so gravity at that particular depth, or gravity on the inner sphere, will be given by the same formula. Now what you need to do, now wherever you got capital R, now capital R will be replaced by R minus D. Now remember, now capital R will be replaced by now R minus D, because you already know now the radius of the inner sphere will be R minus D. That's the reason why now the gravity at that particular depth, or the gravity at that particular depth, will be given by the same formula. Now only thing you need to remember, now wherever we got radius, now that will be replaced by now R minus D. So therefore, now I can write, now the gravity at the depth is given by, so now gravity at the depth is given by, so I can write, now GD will be numerically equal to, now K multiplied by, now the radius of the inner sphere will be R minus D, now multiplied by rho. Now that will be, now equation number 2, what that will be? Now that will be the equation number 2, what that will be? The gravity we got on the inner sphere, or that is the gravity we got at that particular depth D, that will be given by the formula. So GD will be numerically equal to now K into R minus D, now multiplied by rho. So now further, now what we need to do, now what I will do, now I will divide now equation 2 by equation number 1. So now if I remove the diagram, so if I remove the diagram, now what I will do, now I will divide now equation 2 by equation number 1. Now let us see now what we get. So now I can say now divide, now I can say now divide now equation 2 by equation 1. So therefore, now what I am going to get, so GD divided by G will be numerically equal to now K into R minus D multiplied by rho whole divided by now KR into rho. Now what will happen? So now what will happen? Now K and K will be getting cancelled. Now rho and rho will be getting cancelled. Now what will be remaining? So we get now GD divided by G will be numerically equal to now r minus d now divided by r. Now this r can be further written. Now what I will do, I will split the denominator. So if I'm splitting the denominator, then what will happen? So therefore, now I can write GD divided by G will be numerically equal to now R divided by R minus D divided by R. So what will happen? Now R and R will be getting cancelled. So now therefore, now what will be remaining? Now GD divided by G will be numerically equal to now 1 minus D divided by R. So what I am getting by dividing now both the equations, now GD divided by G will be numerically equal to now 1 minus D divided by R. Now what you do, now you cross multiply G. So therefore, now what I am getting, so GD will be numerically equal to now G multiplied by now 1 minus D by R. So now therefore, now what you are getting, now the gravity at that altitude, or the gravity at that depth will be given by the formula. So GD will be numerically equal to now G multiplied by now 1 minus D by R. Now remember, now this will be the general formula, or this will be the master formula we got for the gravity at any depth D, now below the surface of the earth, that will be given by the formula. So GD will be numerically equal to now G multiplied by now 1 minus V by R. So now remember, now that is the formula we got for the gravity at any depth, or that is the expression we got for the gravity at any depth. So now, can anybody not tell me? So now, one special case I will take here. So now, one special case we can take here. So now, can anybody not tell me? Now, what will happen at the center of the earth? So, let us take one special case. Now, can anybody not tell me? Now, what will happen at the center of the earth? So now, can anybody not tell me, now what will happen at the center of the earth, or what will happen to the gravity at the center of the earth? So remember, now initially, now what we are doing, we are keeping the body on the surface of the earth, and as long as the body will be kept on the surface of the earth, then the gravity will always be maximum. So now, what we are doing, so now the body will be penetrating or the body will be made to penetrate not deeper and deeper into the earth crust. So now the question will be, now what will happen when the body will be reaching the center of the earth? So now what will happen when the body will be reaching the center of the earth? So it is very clear, when the body will be reaching the center of the earth, then remember, now the depth, then remember, now the depth will be numerically equal to radius, or remember, so now, remember, so whenever the body will be reaching the center of the earth, then remember, now the depth of the body will be numerically equal to the radius of the earth, or remember, now whenever the body will be reaching the center of the earth, then the depth will be numerically equal to radius. So in this case, now D will be numerically equal to R. So if I put now, so in the in this formula, so if I put now D will be equal to R, then now what I am going to get? So in this formula, now what I will do, now wherever we got D, now that will be numerically equal to the radius of the earth, then what will happen? Now the gravity at the center will be denoted by G naught. So let us say, now the gravity at the center will be denoted by G naught. So G naught will be numerically equal to G multiplied by now 1 minus R divided by R. So R and R will get cancelled. So gravity at the center of the earth will be numerically equal to G into 1 minus 1. So 1 minus 1 will be equal to 0. So implies the gravity at the center of the earth will always be equal to 0. Or remember, now the gravity at the center of the earth will always be equal to 0. So therefore, now what will be the conclusion we got, or what will be the conclusion we got? Now remember, now we are getting a minus sign. So now, what does the minus sign will be indicating, or what does the minus sign will be indicating? Now remember, now very carefully, now as long as the body will be remaining on the surface of the earth, or as long as the body will be resting on the surface of the earth, then the gravity will always be maximum. But whenever the body will be penetrating not deeper and deeper under the earth crust, then remember, the gravity will be gradually decreasing, and finally it will become zero at the center of the earth. So remember, Now remember, now that will be the conclusion we got. Or remember, now what do you mean by the variation of gravity along with the depth? So in a very simple manner, now I can say the conclusion, now as long as the body will be resting on the surface of the earth, or as long as the body will be resting on the surface of the earth, then the gravity will always be maximum. But whenever the body will be penetrating now deeper and deeper under the earth crust, then the gravity will be gradually decreasing and finally it will become zero at the center of the earth. So that is what we call the variation of gravity. Now along with the depth, or that is what we call the variation of the gravity, now along with the depth. So now once again, now remember the conclusion, or once again, now remember the conclusion, now as long as the body will be resting on the surface of the earth, or as long as the body will be resting on the surface of the earth, then the gravity will always be maximum. But whenever the body will be penetrating now deeper and deeper under the earth crust, then the gravity will be gradually decreasing and finally it will become zero at the center of the earth. So that is what we call the variation of gravity now along with the depth. So that's all for today. So that's a fantastic topic we got. So variation of gravity along with the depth.